this is my pastel paint, my pastel thing I did.
And this is what I sharpen my pencils with. Inside the car.
Oh.
You don't want it at all?
Yeah, I'm taking it, driving it
down. Oh, I see. Oh, well, we don't have far to go, darling. It's so just leave it like that.
With their music at all, you know, the Daryl Hall always...
Here we go, folks. We're driving down the road there.
No, not this time.
Go on.
Cindy and I were pursued on a painting here yesterday.
No. Am I supposed to talk?
Okay.
Would I actually have this famous painting as well?
This is my friend Cindy.
This is
from New York. We can never know about the days to come, but we think about them. And I wonder if I'm really with you now, or
helplessly hoping her heart can have us nearby. I forgot the words. Looking hovers nearby, waiting in words, only to trip at the sounds of goodbye.
It seems to be in a fashion.
What are you getting?
I'm going to get the cat toy and I chase her.
What's it called?
It's called the kitten fishing rod.
Okay, you go get that. So how many cats have you got?
Nine cats, six kittens. Difference.
So you sell Bengals, do you?
I do sell Bengals, and they're very beautiful cats.
There's a lot of big demand for them, isn't
yeah.
there?
They're a breed that got accidentally created in the 60s. They had an Asian leopard cat put with a tabby.
Oh, really?
They mated, and they didn't expect them to mate. And so now we've got this lovely breed that's kind of new.
And the leopard-type cat, that was a little leopard, it wasn't a big one.
It's an Asian leopard cat. It's maybe about 3 feet long, bigger than a house cat, and very beautiful markings. They live in the jungle of Malaysia. These are the Bengal cats, and baby, this is a very beautiful one. Do you see his markings?
Look at those.
Look at that. He's a good boy.
And there's a lot of people who buy them,
Yeah, they're very popular just because they're so wild looking. They look like the, leopards and little mini leopards, but very friendly.
Here they come. Here comes a bunch of them.
So they're...
So this is a little long-haired one. She's called a cashmere.
And how long have you been breeding them for?
About 4 years. Started with a grandmother of these, and I now have the grandmother's daughter and her daughter are the two mothers that I have. They definitely want more protein than regular cats. They're a little bit closer to the wild. They can jump from standing position to the top of a door and lie on the little edge of the door. They can jump about just 6 feet without, 6 or 7 feet. The average price is about 500 to 800.
Yeah.
For a pet. Yeah, the higher prices are when you're breeding them, but I never sell any of my kittens as breeders. I sell them always as pets. This one, this is the amazing markings. Come on,
look
baby.
At that.
Come on. And they go through a phase where their eyes are brown, but they, at about 7 or 8 months, they become green. Oh, Bobby.
I think I'm 6'5" too. Are we the same height, do you think?
You look about the same height.
Wow. Probably, yeah.
Yep.
Wow. How tall are you?
I'm 5'9". I'm a little shrimp in the family.
Teeny weeny little 5'9". Look, see yeah. How short she is?
Yeah, I can hardly be in the picture.
See, there's little Magdalen. Hey, Laurie, come over here. I want to compare you two. So there's little Magdalen. No, right there, right there's good. There's little Magdalen.
Here I am.
And then, and then here's Laurie, her nephew. Yes. And then let's see your aunt again. There she is.
Just tiny.
Little Magdalen, right next to her giant nephew.
Rawr.
There we go. There were precious few paintings of you in there, aren't there?
I know, we're going to have to work on that.
I didn't see any paintings of you.
Well, yep, that's true.
That's too bad, eh?
Yes.
Your worries and your strife. I mean the bare necessities or Mother Nature's recipes that bring the bare necessities of life. Wherever I wander, wherever I roam, I couldn't be fonder of my big home. The bees are buzzing in the tree to make some honey just for me. You look under the rocks and plants and take a glance at the fancy ants, then maybe try a few. The bare necessities of life will come to you. They'll come to you. Look for the bare necessities, the simple bare necessities. Forget about your worries and your strife. I mean the bare necessities, that's why a bear can rest at ease with just the bare necessities of life. When you pick a pawpaw or prickly pear, and you prick a raw paw, next time beware. Don't pick the prickly pear by paw. When you pick a pear, try to use the claw. But you don't need to use the claw when you pick a pear of the big pawpaw. Have I given you a clue? The bare necessities of life will come to you.
Maglum, turn round so we can see, yeah.
So try to relax in my backyard. If you act like that bee acts, you're working too hard. Don't spend your time just looking around for something you want that can't be found. When you find out you can live without it and go along not thinking about it, I'll tell you something true. The bare necessities of life.
Oh, Bengal B. Wilson.
We love you.
The bare necessities of life will come to you. Look for the bare necessities, the simple bare necessities. Forget about your worries and your strife. I mean the bare necessities, that's why a bear can rest at ease. Which is the bare necessities of